Hello guys, my name is Pierre Michel. I'm a math teacher. Today I'm going to tell you about another trick. This trick will help you to read three people's mind. This is an incredible trick. Before telling you about this trick, I will invite you to subscribe to my channel. You can do so just by clicking on the symbol pi that you can see over here in this part of the screen. Before going forward, let me introduce you to my guests. They are my friends and yours as well. So, let me introduce you to John. Let me introduce you to Jennifer. Finally, let me introduce you to Anthony. They will take part in this experiment today, consisting in reading their minds. Let's go for it. You will tell John to think of a number. John is not supposed to tell about the number he guessed to anyone. So John will take his calculator. He will think of a number between 1 and 9. The number is not supposed to be smaller than 1, nor greater than 9. He will multiply this number by 2. He will add 3 to it. And after that, he's gonna multiply everything by 5. So John will see a number in his calculator after following all these indications. And John will whisper this number to Jennifer. So, you will require from Jennifer to think of a number herself. She's not supposed to tell anyone about this number. Now, what Jennifer will do, Jennifer will take the result she was told by John. She will add her secret number to this result and she will multiply everything by 10. Now, Jennifer will find a second result to the screen of her calculator. Jennifer will then tell her result to Anthony. Jennifer is not going to tell anyone but Anthony the result she found, and Anthony will then take the result of Jennifer, add it to his secret number, and Anthony will find a value which is the final result. And now Anthony will tell you what is his result, the final result. So let's guess Anthony told you that he found 287. This is an example, of course. So the only thing that you have to do to know precisely the number guessed by John, Jennifer, and Anthony is to subtract 150 from the result given by Anthony. So what you will have to do is 287 minus 150. You can do that in your head, I guess, right? So 287 minus 150 will give you 137. So with a lot of confidence, you can tell John that the number he guessed was 1. You can tell Jennifer that the number she guessed was 3. And Anthony that the number he guessed himself was 7. I can assure you that this trick will work whatever the number you will choose from 1 to 9. Let's say John chose 1. It will multiply it by 2 plus 3, which will give 5. Finally, it will multiply 5 times 5. That will give 25. John will tell Jennifer that the number is 25. Jennifer now will add 3 to 25. So the secret number of Jennifer is number 3. Jennifer is not gonna tell anyone that the number is 3. So 25 plus 3 gives 28 times 10. That will give us 280. Jennifer will whisper the second number, which is 280, to Anthony. Now, Anthony will choose, let's say, 7. So 280 plus 7 equals 287. Remember, John guessed number 1, Jennifer guessed number 3, and Anthony guessed number 7. Now the answer is 287. So what we do, mentally, you will do 287 minus 150, which gives 137. So the number guessed by John is 1, the number guessed by Jennifer is 3, and the number guessed by Anthony is 7. Let's do the mathematical demonstration to show you that this trick will work whatever the number you may choose between 1 and 9. We're gonna use algebra to understand the logic behind it. So, as I told you, remember, right? I told you that John will think of a number. This number will be x. It will multiply it by 2 plus 3 times 5. So in that case, the result will be 10x plus 15. Second step. It will tell this number 10x plus 15 to Jennifer. Jennifer will add her secret number to it. Let's assume that the secret number of Jennifer is y in this case. So we have 10x plus 15 plus y times 10. It will give us 100x plus 150 plus 10y. This is the result found by Jennifer. Jennifer will communicate this result to Anthony. Anthony will then take 100x plus 150 plus 10y plus his secret number, which is z. Now, Anthony will tell you that the final result is 100x plus 150 plus 10y plus z. And on your side, what you have to do to tell with a level of confidence of 100% what is the number guessed by each one of them is to take this expression and to subtract 150 from it. And finally, you will have 100x plus 10y plus z. This result will allow you to tell with a level of confidence of 100% that the first number is x, the second number is y, and the third number is z. Remember, in the previous example, when I had 287 minus 150, it gave me 137. 137 is actually 100 times 1 plus 10 times 3 plus 7. In this case, 1 is our x, 3 is our y, and 7 is our z. So guys, I hope that you understand the trick. And if you like this video, don't forget to express yourself. And overall, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you next time.